think that one day you will leave planet Earth.
You know you will. That's why you've written a will.
True, isn't it?
Now, ladies and gentlemen, do you know where you're going?
I do.
Now, look, I'm going to ask you another question. Do you think I've ever stolen? Do you think me, this beautiful angelic face that I've had for 57 years, came with the rest of the body, do you think I've ever stolen? If you ring my brother David, who lives in Blackburn, he will say yes. Because he was the guy who lost the money. So I've stolen. Do you think I've ever sworn? I have. Do you think I've ever blasphemed? I have. Now, if I was one of them people and I was no longer here, do you think, having done all those things wrong, I'd be in heaven or not? What do you think? The gentleman, is that a nice cup of coffee? Oh, what is it? What's in there?
I'm Tinto.
Now listen, I'm going to ask you a question. If you give me one of these, do you think I can know where I am next? Do you think it's possible to know? If you don't know the answer, you say I don't know.
Yes.
You think that it's possible to know?
Yeah.
You sure you know that?
Yeah.
Okay. Does anybody else know? Do you know that? You think it's possible to know where you go next?
Yeah.
Is it possible, ladies and gentlemen, they put me in my little box and say goodbye to me and say, he was a good boy, yeah? Do you think it's possible to know where I am? It is. I'll tell you why. The only people who get to heaven are sinners. Forgive me. Isn't that good? It's like me saying, I'm going to run an hospital and everybody who comes to this hospital has got to be well. What about that? What would you think about that? Everybody who goes to the hospital this afternoon in queue can only show up and be treated if they're well. What's wrong with that? Well, why are they being treated if they're well? See, people think that you've got to be good. You don't have to be good, you've got to be sick. And you don't have to be sick of being thrown. I mean sick. No, you've done wrong. So I know I've done wrong. And Jesus came for people like me. Do you remember next to him there's a man who died called the dying thief? He was a thief. How do you become a thief? Answer, go into Holland and Barrett and wed somebody. Then you're a thief. It's obvious, isn't it? So if thieves get this word from Jesus, this day you'll be with me in paradise, is Jesus interested in people who think they're good? No. He said, I've only come to call sinners, and I'm really pleased, because that involves me. Now, I haven't murdered anybody like Asher, in Brady, and I have robbed a few things, but I haven't done a bank, so I'm not on that scale. Yeah? But look, let's imagine that this man here, in the 1940s top, okay, my friend Jeff. Jeff, you sit a maths exam, and I sit a maths exam, same day, same room. He gets 90 on 100, and I get 50. Who's passed?
Depends what the pass rate is.
Drink your tea, you. He gets 90, and I get 50 on the same exam. Who's passed? Well, if the pass rate is 1, I'm laughing. And so is Jeff, and he's 1940. Yeah? If the pass rate is 51, who's laughing now? Who's not so happy? Me, because I've got a weak sin. Ladies and gentlemen, do you know what God's passphrase is? Perfection! So if you don't eat perfection, you don't get to heaven. But we can't do that. Nobody can do that. Here's some good news, right? He only came for people who've done wrong. That's why he died on the cross. Can you think of anybody who could love 10 lepers? And only one came back and Jesus said, where are the other 9? I cured 10. Where's the other 9? People didn't respect him, did they? They didn't acknowledge him. They laughed at him. They stuck him on a cross. And Jesus on the cross died so you'd be safe. Folks, look here. One day this will be you. Put your hand up if you don't believe me. You must be stupid if you don't believe me. One Joan Rivers, comedian. I mean, one day you'll take your final breath. When I meet you again, will you have less beat in your heart or more left? It's obvious. So do yourself a favour, folks. Tune into what I'm saying. Here's some great news. Jesus will forgive anybody who's honest enough to say they're wrong. There are very few people can say they're wrong. True. Jesus said, I've come to save sinners. That means you've got to say, I'm wrong. He's right. Can you find out where he was wrong? But ladies and gentlemen, he died on a cross to let you off. Look at this little piece of information. I mean, these guys who tell me they don't believe in God. I like to challenge them. Look, for those who don't believe in God, are you ready? Ready? God does not believe in atheists. Not the atheists. Think about that. So if he doesn't believe in atheists, and there's thousands of them today in Southport, millions on planet Earth, does he then mean that if you don't believe in God, you've eliminated him? No. Isn't he good to see you? So, ladies and gentlemen, what I'm saying is this. That Jesus loves you enough. You might be 50, you might be 60, you might be 70. My mum's 93. And she's come to ask Jesus to forgive her. And ladies and gentlemen, one day it'll be your turn. I'm not being morbid. But if you don't do your soul a favour, you're stupid. Because you can do your soul a favour. You can prepare for your trip into eternity. And Jesus says, now I'm going to finish there, and I offer to people a little gospel. And the reason I offer this, ladies and gentlemen, is because this is the most powerful book in the world, this, that's changed more lives of more wicked people than any book I know. And it says in there, in John 10, verse 10, I've come that you may have life. Do you know what these people all wanted? They wanted life, but they lost their lives. Jesus says, I can give you eternal life. It's great, isn't it? It's free. Would you like it? He loved you enough on the cross, and he died there, hanging there before his mum, in agony and shame. And he can forgive anybody. I'm going to stop there. I'm offering this to anybody who'll take it home and read it. If it's a load of rubbish, you can find all the mistakes. If you like not just going to take it from my hand, that's all you've got to do. Ladies and gentlemen, it's free. I come. Anybody else want a little gospel of John? I've come that you may have life. God bless you, madam. Have a lovely afternoon. Nice to see you.